Set it off, you the bomb. Must I beat it down like I'm Donkey Kong? Girl, you know I'm nasty like the underarm. Swear to God, cause I bang bang like AK strap overarm. Here's a charm, you can loop it in your food chain. Just make sure the neighbors know my name. And I'm trying to penetrate your hall of fame with the stinky leg. Hands behind my head, watch the young player do his thing.
Excuse me, please don't go.
In a trance, watch her dance. Look at how she move around. Emotions teleported. I think they're somewhere up in the clouds. Watch them fall, cats and dogs pouring down. I see them now. She turned around. I panic wild. Tell me if you need a clown. I see it now. Her kids laughing. You miss a chance to be my dad. Then I woke up with a gas. She saw me laugh. I kindly asked, will you accept everything that I have? I know it's fast. Just no forever sign. I'm yours truly, your favorite fan.
To the wall. Welcome to the wall. And in case you didn't know, we are the
Atlanta Podcast.
And I said the Atlanta Podcast.
Bang, bang.
Having a mic malfunction.
Oh my gosh, man. She had all day to figure this
mic
out.
Mic malfunction, aka erectile dysfunction.
aka, boy, the worst.
The
aka,
worst.
Don't do nothing. Let's do this.
So, as usual,
it's definitely not as usual.
We're pretty short today.
Yeah. Really short, right?
So, who's in the house is Sir Django.
Bang, bang, boomerang.
Barbados.
So,
and that's it.
Well, we might have somebody slip in a little later.
Might slide we through. Might.
Slide through like the Donald. Slide off. Do a little groping on the mic.
Just a little grope.
Just a little... That's terrible. That's
not
it.
Too much groping though.
Just
sexual assault.
This
a gentle grope.
Yeah, you know, the appropriate amount.
The appropriate.
Yeah, you know, just a little hello. You know. So Barbados, what are we talking about today?
All right, so today we're gonna go into our main topic, which is, does higher education equal a higher paycheck?
Oh,
now why are we talking about this? What happened?
Yeah, why?
Somebody having some crisis already?
Yeah, let's explain this.
Well, we're gonna get into it,
but
definitely a lot of things prompted why we talk about this, mainly because you know, a lot of us have been through school, mm-hmm. are still in school, thinking about going to school. So mm-hmm.
it's nonsense.
I think it's a good thing.
was it to talk
about it?
Okay.
So go ahead and. Take it away.
All right, we're going to jump right in. So basically, this episode is going to be about the benefits of higher education mm-hmm. and the potential setbacks and pros and cons of giving your money to the government. So,
besides the IRS, right?
Yeah, besides the IRS. So, me and Bam Bang went over this in detail the other day. Mm-hmm. And we found out a lot of interesting articles and a lot of interesting information and stats that point more towards it may not be as beneficial as we once thought it was.
Is that the conclusion you're already forming? You have like a whole list of notes.
Well, that's the conclusion that I formed after everything. I'm always nervous because
like 20 lines
because you're always staring down my throat. So
she skipped like all her notes.
Bang Bang.
You mean y'all notes?
Her notes.
Are you sure, my dude?
Yeah, she skipped all the way down to mine. If you go up, look.
Right.
Where's all your notes right there?
Well, I thought we just agreed that we're going to jump right into the topic and save this portion to the last part.
I didn't see that portion.
That's what I'm saying. Nobody agreed to anything.
Oh, so do you want to start over or something?
Oh, no, we ain't starting all over. Let's jump right into the topic.
So what did I miss? Hold on. What were you going to say?
Well, we were going to do the intro. We did the intro. Then we're going to do the announcements. And then we're going to jump into the topic.
Why did you skip all that?
What's the announcements?
Because Sir Django wanted to leave the headlines to the last part.
Okay, we're good then. All right, let's go to the topic.
Anyway.
That's what we was doing, my dude.
Ask the question.
Anyway. The
question. He did ask the question.
Does higher education equal higher pay?
Yeah.
So what we did was we did some research on a video from Forbes.com. Not from Forbes. From WorldStar.
Flags.
No.
It's flags. A pretty legitimate video.
I was thinking the same thing.
It was a pretty legitimate video, and it basically talked about how...
What, they fight the professor?
No, it's actually a pretty decent video. I can't remember the name. What was the title?
Maybe an interview?
I think there was some
fighting. You gonna give me a job? WorldStar. WorldStar.
What was the title, Bang Bang?
Give me a job, my nigga.
Oh no. The title was A Black 1%.
So right.
That's how we kind of spiraled into this topic.
So, y'all went on an internet journey?
Well, no. Somebody sent us. So we were supposed to have some, our people come through.
We were supposed to have some real ones come through. But
that happened for me, too. So everybody canceled.
You know how it goes, man.
Hey, what you doing?
Cool.
I'm out of town. Really?
I'm on the toilet. Okay.
Yeah, we need friends with like no life or something like that.
With
so,
no life.
So
you got to give them that 2-week notice of.
Yeah, I know, right?
You know,
a
older
Google calendar reminder.
Married people though.
So
I'm married.
So
you got to give me a heads up,
bro. That's love, man.
That is love. You can't fight that.
My girl gonna be like, "What am I doing?" That's how you talk when you're married. You go from being cool. Hey, what's up?
To be in stress. It doesn't work like that. Marriage is a beautiful thing.
What my wife gonna say?
It's a beautiful thing.
I am the wife. That's how I talk.
Yeah, right.
Well, I'm a woman.
Sir Django, you hate it.
I do.
Yeah, Sir Django is really sound like a hater in this piece.
So Django hating y'all.
I'm not hating. I'm talking about married people. You gotta.
That's
you can't invite married people out. The same, you gotta give a heads up. That's all I'm saying. They need like a week notice because I'm married.
We gotta find babysitters and whatnot.
Even though I got kids, we was planning Netflix night. We was gonna watch.
Man, that Netflix is crucial, man.
It is crucial.
We're gonna watch Luke Cage.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we were.
Lazy my night, man.
Is it?
Bae was binge watching that shit last week.
I had to, man. That's the blackest show ever, boy.
And then
the wackest.
And then we gonna walk the dog.
Yeah. Working on that too, my dude.
Oh yeah, that's right. You got an announcement about the dog situation or no? You gonna say that?
Still broke. Still trying to figure things out in life.
So we'll say that until you get there.
We might have him on the podcast. Maybe he'll show up, put like a little doggy bowl or something like that.
Wolf.
Yeah.
I'm lost. So, anyway. All right,
so
we watched this video, and it talked about black people being the 1% of the 1% in America.
All right.
And that 1%.
First of all, we're not going to have Barbados explain stuff. All right. It's been all over the place. So this is what happened. We went to WorldStar, right, to look up fights. And then what we found.
So y'all was on fights.
Nah, a few. So then what we found that they had an article on the black 1%.
Yeah.
So what they were trying to do was trying to debunk like some of the rumors that they have about the 1%. They were saying things like, we're not all uppity, stuck up, so on and so on, right? So
meaning the black upper class.
Right.
The black wealthy.
The black wealthy and what their contribution is to the community. So it was kind of like an interview, and they interviewed the lady who owned BET, right? And they interviewed another couple. It was a black, African American male, and he kind of grew a business from like the ground up. He grew up on the other side of the tracks, that he said, right? And they basically was talking about their point of views. So that's how we got into it. So continue, Barbados.
Yeah. So they talked about being the 1% of the 1%, and how black people in America, their wealth doesn't really compare to that of white households.
Mm-hmm.
So they dropped some stats. basically saying that, you know, only if you look at it as a dollar. Mm-hmm. So white people hold that whole dollar.
I mean,
of the wealth.
But you can't, you skipping like a lot. The thing was, this is what they're trying to say. They're saying that there's such thing as a racial wealth gap. You heard of that?
Of course. But go, for people who don't know, explain it.
So, can you explain it, Barbados? What a racial
no,
wealth
I
gap?
Can't.
Right. So basically, so in other words, one group of individuals tends to make a higher dollar amount versus another. So, mm-hmm. and this exactly. what's going on right now is black households are earning less compared to other individuals. Right?
Yeah.
Other, yeah.
Even compared to Hispanics.
Too. Minority spirit, you know. So yeah. The racial wealth gap.
Yeah,
is about
but
the
even I remember seeing Black America like make less than Latino. It's very chronic. It's chronic poverty. Like it's super poor.
That's true.
There's a lot of $10,000 households.
Yeah.
You know, like families, not just one person. Yeah. Like a family living off like $12,000. It's like how do you do that?
So, what's crazy? Like that article was kind of. Not only they're interviewing those black millionaire billionaires. Yeah. There's also putting stats about mm-hmm. the black community. So they're saying things like, "Do you feel obligated to have to help the black community?" And they're saying things like, "You gotta help your people," which was surprising to me. I didn't think they were say those things, right? Mm-hmm. But because we don't tend to get that much help. Like when I reach out, I don't get that much help. You don't get a lot of serious people and so on and so on.
Maybe, but how do you access those people though? I think that's the question.
And that's something we
You know, because I'm thinking about like organizations. You know, there's groups. You know what I mean? Like, they're not just gonna be walking down the street. Hey, what's
hey,
up?
Come through.
You got a meal? Help me out. You know, gotta wear on. I'm broke.
So, do you feel like you gotta actually kind of prove that you're serious? Because it feels like sometimes when you're in, I guess, in a different demographic, you have to prove that you're not about that bull. They're not going to just welcome you in.
What do you mean? Like, talking about the wealthy or? Oh.
So, if I meet somebody for the first time, yeah, I'm going to always have, like, my red flag. You know, I'm be looking for red flags.
Yeah.
Do you think everybody's the same way, or is that more of, like, a racial thing?
I mean,
it depends.
I don't know. That depends on the individual.
So, are you talking about, like, if it's networking, then you just see where it goes.
Right.
You know, like, add me on LinkedIn, shoot me an email. Mm-hmm. Blah, blah, blah. But for other things, if it's like, hey, you know, trying to do business or something else, you just, you're cautiously optimistic. And you just hope that person, it's just like if you use a business the first time.
I agree.
You go, you get your oil changed or do something at a place you've never been to. You just say, all right, the reviews don't seem too bad. Yeah. You might check Yelp or online. You hope, don't mess up your car or use I'm thinking about when I move in, I might hire a cleaning service. Just so, for the sake of time, I'm like, I hope they do a good job versus they do scrub bubbles on my toilet and leave. So, you know, you put out that faith that, you know, you put out the faith, but at the back of your mind, you're like, they could be shitty.
And I think that's a good approach because you have to be cautious. And at the same time, I don't care who you are, where you're from, what you're doing. If I think it's important to, we'll only mess with people who are actually doing something in the process, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, because
I know, but there's so many people who are not doing it.
But it's so much. It's so. it seems like it's so easy to get out there and at least try to attempt, make some kind of effort.
And there's so many people who just be bullshitting though.
So why? I would definitely want to mess with the people who bull. You know what I mean? Because it shows in your worth ethic. If you haven't took the time out to really accomplish it on your own, then are you really serious about it? Type thing. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's like the attitude with people they deal with in school. Why some kids, when they get out of school, they don't necessarily get a job as quickly. A lot of times because they have in their...
They're not grinding.
They're not grinding hard enough, right?
Work ethic.
So we skip a big portion again. So
what about to... So we talked about just generally higher education and you're watching the videos and you got to the World Star video that's not about fighting.
Right. So it made me think about wealth in a sense. And they're talking about helping communities and things like that, but nobody ever talked about how do you build wealth.
What's the steps? What's the process?
Well, what's the best way of building wealth? How do we build wealth? What do we know as far as the keys to building wealth?
Do you mean as far as African Americans? What we know?
I don't want to make it African American. I think just it's a people thing.
Just generally speaking, right? I mean.
Well, what I think of as wealth, in my perspective, I don't know about anybody else. I think about savings. What do I have in the bank?
Mm-hmm. How do you how do you get savings? Just say.
Well, if I'm working a job and I'm able to save. Mm-hmm. Then I put whatever portion that I can afford into a savings account, yeah. And I build upon it.
Yeah.
And, you know, to me, what I have saved versus, you know, what I spend or have to pay for.
Yeah, your
month.
Cash flows versus outflows versus inflows. Yeah.
But
yeah.
How are you getting? You're saying you just get money.
So for me, it's about owning versus renting.
But how are we getting that? Money to own, how are we getting that money? How are we gaining that financial gain?
So in terms of the cash flows?
Yeah, because like
we might have to work with somebody else for a while.
Yeah, because I don't own my own business.
Mm-hmm.
I
right
work
now.
For somebody else.
Yeah.
So how do you, so the steps is, let's say I just came to this country, got my green card or whatever, mm-hmm. or I just graduated high school, I got no money, right?
You mm-hmm. live in with family first, but you don't have your own spot probably.
So then what I do after that to make money, I just go to like Walmart and say, hey, you guys hiring? Or like, what's the process to like, how do you begin? How do you start to make wealth, to build wealth?
You earn income somehow.
Somehow.
So to your point about immigrants, cab, cleaning, mm-hmm. Manual labor, like you're going to get it in somehow.
Yeah.
And then you use that to segue into something else. Hopefully become the owner of a business.
Yeah. But
what happens is, if I own the business, I might sell it off to maybe one of the immigrants and he becomes the owner.
Franchises.
Yeah, or something, yeah.
So what percentage of our peers do we know own businesses?
Maybe like
out of 10? Maybe out of 100?
I don't have 100
5.
Peers.
Five.
Like 5, right?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it has to be like 5 out of 100.
Well, for that reason, I think for the most of us, going to school is that way of building wealth.
Of
right.
getting mm-hmm. the skills to get a good paying job.
Because if you get out of school, you got nothing. Everybody says, get a job, get this, or get money mm-hmm. and save it. All these other tips to say, hey, this is how you build it. But it's like, wait, how am I getting this money?
Mm-hmm.
Most of us go to school to get it,
mm-hmm.
right? And it seems like the automatic choice coming out of high school, right?
Right.
It's like the only choice.
If you don't have a mentor.
It's expected, yeah.
Yeah.
People expect that.
Why is that, though?
Just because it's the norm.
I don't think so. I think if you have a mentor, they'd be like, I think poor, if you come from a low-income household
mm-hmm.
or middle-class households, like, go to school.
Yeah.
Because if you got a millionaire family, they're going to be like, do X, Y, Z.
Mm-hmm. Right.
They might tell you to go to Harvard or something just because it is what it is. But that's going to be for networking, and that's just because where upper-class families go.
Yeah.
But really, I mean, like, they don't tell you what to major in or what organizations to join or what scholarships to apply to. They just tell you one thing. You got to navigate everything by yourself.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my experience, I didn't have people telling me what to do or you should join this or do this
mm-hmm.
or if you want a job, do this or network with these people.
Mm-hmm.
It's just this general go to school. Like, what does that even mean?
Yeah,
go
I
to
mean, it's crazy,
like, how do
right?
I pick a school? How do I, because really what they should tell you is apply to like 10 schools. Well, wait, we can't afford to spend $50 per application.
Mm-hmm.
But if you apply to 10 schools, there's a chance two of them might give you a scholarship.
True.
So it's just like, is
the
bullshit.
Thing is, though, they tell you these things, but
no,
how many of us are
no guidance.
Doing,
no guidance.
Right? So in the inner city schools that we grew up in, nobody was doing that stuff. We sat down those classes where they went mm-hmm. through all the, you know, hey, go to college. Pick
and
out your college.
I do want to say, so just to play devil's advocate, it's like, well, you can look on the internet. I didn't think about that.
Nobody's thinking
not
about
as an
that.
18
when you're
year
like
old
17, 17, 18.
Yeah, right. It's tough, right?
You're not. How do you think how to best go through higher education?
I mean, you really don't know.
Because basically, a lot of shit starts when you're like 15, 16.
You right. never know by yourself. So
yeah.
the one thing that I got from that interview that I watched,
yeah,
from World Star. it was that they said that most Americans will think that people who are in lower class situations got to pull themselves up by the bootstraps.
It's like, how you do that?
Right? And mm-hmm. then his argument was, what happens if you don't have boots? Mm-hmm. And a lot of us didn't have those boots mm-hmm. going in. Yeah. All we were saying was like, hey, basically what we talked about when we first started, just get it, you know, just put it in the bank, you know, just save it.
Mm-hmm. But where is that really cash no coming from? Yeah.
Where there's no plan. There's no effort. It was just go to school. And that's all we think about. Go to school and don't go to community college.
But what school, you know, what school specializes in what? It's just,
there was no guidance. It was just throwing a bone out there and expecting mm-hmm. you how to make gumbo out of a bone. Yeah.
So you was like, okay. It was like, they gave you some clam chowder and it was like, hey, man, in a crock pot. And it was like, hey,
was like, figure out how to make something. What? Isn't there more to this shit?
Crazy, right?
Yeah.
So I guess it's like they kind of threw you in there.
It's just like saying, "Hey, go to Canada." What street do I? What road do I take? Do I catch a flight? Do I take a bus? Do I drive there? Well, you just got to go to Canada, my dude. You know what I'm saying? So it's just in terms of direction. I think just like that.
Right.
They just tell you, "Hey, here it's like GPS." Just imagine GPS that gives you the final destination, but no directions. Like you just say, hey, I want to go here. I want to go to this destination, but all right, we're not going to tell you where to turn or.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's.
But the thing is, a lot of our parents just want us to succeed. A lot of our parents just want us to do better. And a lot of times, if they haven't gone through the process, they don't know what to tell you. Mm-hmm. I think that's why it's so dope for us to have to go through the process to have a better clue and say, hey, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this.
Yeah.
A lot of them don't have those boots. Right?
And then it's just what school you go to makes a difference. You know what I mean? So you just can't. One mistake is just saying you want to go to school. Because first of all, not all schools are equal. Not all schools specialize in the same thing. And not all schools have the same relationships. Certain schools have, like, a huge alumni team. Well, not a team. A huge alumni base, I guess is the word I'm looking for.
Yeah.
So if you say, hey, what's the chance of me running to alumni for a school? Maybe you want to go to that school. But if you say, hey, I want to go to school, you know, it's like football team for traditional experience versus if you want to get into sciences, you may want to go to this place. What if you wanted to get a scholarship? Mm-hmm. You might have to go to the no-name school, University of, Doodoo Brown, Wisconsin Catholic University. Like, what the fuck is that?
Brown College.
Yeah, Doodoo Brown, Uncle Luke, Shake Dad School.
Shake Dad School.
Uncle Luke, Miami, Dade County University.
What will be an Uncle Luke Shake Dad School commercial sound like?
Just like them.
ICDC College.
Drop the books. Let me see you get that work.
Just like that. Remember the Everest guy?
What's that?
He ain't doing. He'd be just like the Everest guy, but just like the twerk song. You ain't doing nothing. You ain't doing nothing. Shake. We gotta have an amateur night. Win a scholarship. Friday, Uncle.
He's talking about. Are you tired? Or
yeah.
Are you tired of sitting at home and just doing nothing but taking Instagram pictures?
Are you tired of fucking with this bum dude? Come upgrade your entire life, Uncle Luke Shake Dance. Come to Uncle Luke Shake Dance School for gifted students.
Gifted booties.
Gifted.
That's terrible.
The gifted booties of America.
If your booty has potential, come to the
UBBT or UBUTT.
Yeah, University. Of booty. UGB, University of Gifted Booty.
Okay. So at university, get the booty.
Yeah.
The reason why it's so appealing too, because we all been told that go to school, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So what I found out, what we looked up, is that it says with a bachelor's degree is accounted for an average of $16,000 additional income per year that you get if you don't get your diploma, right?
Mm-hmm. That's crazy. That's a big difference. Yeah.
Per year, that is redonkulous, right?
That's travel. That's saving for a home. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a lot of shit.
They said that's more than like $500,000
over your lifetime, right?
Right. Difference in earning of like, I think over your lifetime, right?
Mm-hmm. Or maybe your working career rather. So most
your working career.
Retirement age. Yeah. So that's half a million So basically, that's how if you put half of that in savings, that's right. I mean, you good.
You stuck, right? Mm-hmm. So that kind of had us thinking, right? And we're saying that the way to build wealth, a lot of times we just go to school. Just go to school, you figure it out. And we see why, because obviously it's probably the most safest route to go by. Mm-hmm. And hold on, let me find it. This percentage.
What percentage are you looking for? Uh-oh. Oh, this is gonna be positive stat. But wait a minute. Hold on.
What's that?
I think we got somebody just stepped in the house.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, they kind of sneaked up in here. We might have to adjust.
He did sneak up in there.
He pulled the Donald Trump, but no grope. Yeah. He creeped in, but no he creeped in, but no grope. Is your mic on?
Nah, I'm still not in. And I'm trying to talk to you.
Is the mic not on? Say yeah. Something.
Is my mic on?
I still don't hear it.
Boom. There we go.
You hear it?
Who, what's your name?
Right foot tone at.
Right. So right foot, in case you didn't know, we are the Atlanta podcast.
Yeah. Yeah, the now.
Yeah. So you know like the Ohio State?
Wait, I thought Facebook had this argument.
What argument was that?
Don't call it the Facebook.
What is it? It's Facebook?
Yeah.
Man, fuck.
We can't we call Atlanta. I'm joking.
Man,
I'm about to say,
fuck Facebook.
We love you, Facebook.
I don't care about you, but.
Shit. Facebook don't sponsor anybody.
That's true.
Yeah, I'm about to say, fuck. In fact, they want everybody to pay them. And then they stalk our phones really? On our websites.
Unless
yeah.
you make a marketplace and apparently get paid millions.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Millions.
Are we going to do that?
No.
So fuck Facebook.
They were selling like gophers and weird stuff.
Nigga, we are the
gophers and booty. It was crazy.
The American podcast.
The Atlanta podcast.
The Atlanta podcast.
We gotta say like militant though.
The Atlanta podcast.
So if any of the other podcasts say they're also the Atlanta podcast,
we have to beat them up.
We have to fight straight up.
Fight, man.
We got that copyrighted. Are we gonna at least lie about that we have it copyrighted until we do?
Not even.
We gonna beat them up if they copyright it. They're going to find out who copyright. Going to beat them up.
We're going to fight.
Like, we should copyright it.
Nah, fuck that. Nah. We're just going to leave it uncopywritten. And if somebody copyright, we fight. If you copyright, we will fight. That's the phrase that pays.
We did have the idea first. It's documented.
So, just to
bring you into the convo. Mm-hmm. So, you already know the topic. We're talking about, is school worth? Is that correct?
Does higher education equal higher paycheck?
Does higher education equal higher pay all the time?
Of course not.
Right. Exactly. Right. So what? We went to WorldStar and we found a good article about the black 1%.
So credible.
Yes.
That's
the same
thing I said.
Very credible. Right.
But it checks out. It checks out.
It's super checked out. Right. So we went to the black site. What's it called? WorldStar. We went to WorldStar and they talked about the black 1%. Mm-hmm. Right. Then we found out that the black 1%. Is 1% of the 1%. Crazy, right?
So makes sense.
Yeah.
The 1%.
They're 1% of the normal 1%?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah. They're 1% of the normal
1%. I mean, you think about the population. Yeah.
Crazy, right? We also found out that, I guess, for wealth as a middle class or average individual, for every $1, I guess, a minority makes, a majority makes.
So
a minority makes 6 cents. Am I saying that right?
Yeah. So the whites hold
six cents.
Yeah. So if the whites hold $1 of wealth, mm-hmm. the black percentage only holds 6 cents of that $1.
My gut 6%? Tells
not of that $1.
Well, 6 cents.
Yeah. So 6%
to that
$1. Yeah.
So yeah, he's right. 6%. Yeah.
Crazy, right?
Now. I do feel like that's skewed, though.
Well, yeah. Whoa, that can't be right.
No, I think it is right.
I think it's super right.
Because
right,
there's so many people who live like $10,000 a year. Yeah.
So we
chronic poverty.
You got to get
your headphones on. 6%? Another pen. Right foot. When the last time you've been to Bankhead?
Now, if I heard like 30%.
No, right foot. Bank,
bro.
Yeah. Bank 6%. Head. Bank head.
That has to be
skewed because the richest people are white.
I don't know. But
and they're like drastically richer than everybody else.
Bankhead, my dude.
because they compared it to like the middle class. Hit them with another stat.
So we found this article. So
it's only the middle class.
So it's only for like the average. So it's not taking the 1%.
We're looking at median household income.
Like the average person. So for every average person.
Wait a minute.
That seems unfair.
There's another.
Well, this statistic. So we're talking about wealth.
Oh, just wealth.
The 1% of the 1% is the upper echelon of the society. Mm-hmm. That is not the median.
That's Illuminati. We know.
This is up there.
We know.
So the six cents of that to the $1 is the up there.
$1 is up there.
Yes,
those
is.
Numbers are
because that
out.
Represents the wealth.
That's 6% to a normal. Those white the ones.
I thought we looked that up, but we got more stats.
But those are ones. Those are the ones to the freak parties.
So we looked up an article on Forbes, and it talked about the racial. What was it called? The racial gap.
The racial gap, which is something else they talked about.
Wealth gap.
The racial wealth gap that majorities will hold a certain amount of percentage over the minorities.
Man, I was thinking so 30%.
Nah, man, my dude.
It's crazy.
Let's
say this first because he wasn't here for that. So realized that most people generate their wealth through college. So we wanted to look up colleges first because that's how we generate our wealth through college. So then we found out another stat. And that's the one you're about to read right now, right?
Well, I think we forgot to put it on here. But what the article was saying is that of the median household net worth, whites make up, like $114,000 for median household income. And blacks make up $7,800. And Hispanics are $8,600 or something like that. So those are the stats for median household income across the nation. That's from the U.S. Census Bureau for income.
But go ahead. What's this next one? Median household net worth? That can't be right.
I'm confused by
these
numbers.
Hold on. Wait for this next one.
So median household net worth. Uh-huh. This is from the video. So apparently college grads who are black. Make about $32,780 median household net worth when they graduate with a 4-year degree versus non-college grads who are white who make about $80,000 without a degree.
That is a misinterpretation of data.
But it could. But
I mean, that's what they told.
It could be done.
That's
and
what they
it's,
told you. Yeah, that's.
Hey.
That's like taking one dude and made it. And then saying he is the norm.
I mean, but think about it.
It's about
though.
White comedians, white actors.
Yeah, like
Jim Carrey.
Of course, you're going to get a Bill Gates, but not every white person that didn't go to college is making $80,000.
Not everyone.
Oh, Zuckerberg.
But it's possible.
And to get a median means there's like way above, way below.
So you don't think this will be a factor? Student debt? Do you think like upper class majorities? Or I guess say what we've been saying white people this whole time. You don't think most of them don't graduate with a student debt because they got parents that can afford it, whereas most of us, or minorities, come out with a student.
I think that's too wide.
I think
that's based on class, everything else.
White people are more prepared to go to college while they don't have student debt. So like they would advise a kid to be in state, whereas like a black family would be like, "Boy, you made it to any college, good job. Go and then you'll worry about the finances later."
True.
For white people is. It's a different story.
But even then, I still feel like it's class-based.
That's the same thing.
If you lower class, no matter what race, you're going to make bad decisions.
Like, your parents,
that's what I think too.
My parents, their parents probably didn't go to college. White folks, they got like 4 generations of people going to college.
Mm-hmm. Some families did.
In like the 1800s.
What's crazy, I know,
like the same college.
I'm a first-generation graduate.
Like
I'm first generation.
Exactly my point. I was the first to graduate.
Yeah, it's crazy, right?
But I'm just saying, I seen on Southside, I seen some other races. They look just as fucked.
I mean, that's why
they look
feel
just
that
as
way.
Fucked up as everybody else.
But we got that article, so we went ahead and dissected. And that's some of the things that we got from key points.
Yeah.
And there's a recent article, and it was pretty like, man, it sounds crazy when you think about it. But when you think about when you compare the percentages of the minorities against the majorities, it's I guess it could work.
You know what I just thought of?
Percentage-wise?
Well, would also make college more valuable if I was smashing the professors. I think that
Okay.
Also, I like some Shameless.
All right.
What's y'all watch Shameless?
Shameless.
I haven't watched that.
I don't even know what that is.
Oh, they smashing.
It's like Clueless, but like two or something.
No. This is the best show about like a dysfunctional family.
So
like,
wait, they smashing.
The
professors are smashing. Is that what you're saying?
That's what's up.
The one dude is like not a degenerate in the family. Went to college and he starts smashing his teacher.
Damn.
She was hooking him up. She was taking him to like. Seminars.
Let's, see,
she was that like his boy amazing. Toy.
So,
crazy.
See, wouldn't you say his college experience is more valuable than his peers? he's
sure, 100%. He has like a little black brother though.
That's
but
I've
yet to see anybody else black that could be that kid's mom. You gotta watch the show. It's young, crazy.
Bro, I don't know if I can watch it. It might depend it's on good, you. Man. Just tell me every episode. Hey, what happened? Yeah, they were smashing.
Everything bad.
Okay, cool.
Everything bad.
All right. So it said, so I think, what's that last one? It says typically households, 6% wealth, white households, and Latinos.
Oh, it's just reiterating what we said before. So 6% of the wealth of typical white households. Black household only hold 6%, and Latino households hold
8%. Wait, back to the 6%.
Mm-hmm. 6%.
Does that take in account the super poor and the super rich?
Well, that's why we were saying black people, when it comes to wealth, are the 1% of the 1%. So it's very small, whereas the rest
that's
of us live in
everything.
Poverty
yeah.
or below the.
And what's that?
That's why I think the number is actually, I think it's skewed because
I'm
white
sure
people
it is,
are.
But
that much richer than the richest black person.
But if you get a different person in here, they'll probably argue in a different light. It just depends on how you view the world because we really don't know. We only kind of know what we're going through.
Well, I mean...
Oh, I'm saying from like... To get a median though, I mean, it has to be like a...
Well, these statistics are coming from the Census Bureau, so they can't be too far off.
Well, the Census Bureau is everybody, so that's...
Yeah.
It's everything. That's the richest and the poorest.
Look, the motherfuckers listening... Want to send corrections and let them do it.
Exactly.
Otherwise.
Fact check.
Allegedly 6% of
people. Yeah, yeah. So.
I mean, it is 6%. I'm just saying it's like, I don't see Bill Gates every day.
Yeah. Sure. I mean, I could just look at, you know, I guess when you're out and about in, you know, in your school or your community. And I mean, you can tell that there's a huge difference, you know.
Oh, but I'm not trying to make it. I hate making things a race thing. Like
that's why I said I don't think the 6% is accurate because then it makes it just sound like we're only 6% of a white person.
Black people.
And so many
like,
other
that's
factors.
Not true.
But there's so many
or
other
a normal
factors.
Person.
There's so many factors that aren't involved with that.
Yeah.
And the reason the factors it kind of makes it harder because like we talked about, we're the first. The only thing we know about generating wealth is through school.
So let me.
They're not ownership. We don't learn about ownership.
So
we don't have anybody who owns anything that we know of. So we don't know anything about ownership. All we know is about working for other people.
Yeah.
And another thing that we know about, we don't know about work about school, is that, one, we don't know how to go to school because a lot of times we're the first ones to go through it,
mm-hmm.
right? The
mm-hmm.
first generations to go through
right.
it for the most part. And another reason why, because we don't expand past just the job, the working force, and ownership and employment and so on and so on.
Mm-hmm.
So... I can see why those numbers can be at that point, but at the same time, there's a whole wave of people trying to make that change. Or
I mean, those statistics may very well change in the next
I think five to ten years. Yeah,
yeah.
For sure.
6%.
It's gonna be more than that. You know, 5 to 10 years, but there's gonna be some generations.
I don't think I understand how like small that is.
I mean, that's what we're.
I got
yeah,
six
that's
cents
a significant,
to a white man's dollar.
Oh, it's disgusting.
That's unfortunately, you know.
The thing, if
well,
it, if it's
6% like,
now. Imagine how it was like 20 years ago.
I don't even want to know. So 50
years ago.
So basically what the article was talking about was, you know, yes. what defines wealth. So
mm-hmm.
they said like the main pillar of wealth is home ownership.
Mm-hmm.
So when it comes to most of the black population,
the one,
how many people are owning houses or how many own multiple
properties?
Well,
that's the thing. The argument was that a lot of these people came from the reason why we have such a racial gap is because older generations had property for years and years and years.
Yeah.
And our generations haven't had ownership. At
we
one
weren't
point,
allowed,
wasn't allowed
to yeah.
own, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what
Wait,
they're saying.
Our generation?
Well, not
our
generation.
But,
you know,
two generations ago.
Two generations ago wasn't allowed
oh.
to.
Well, no. That'd be three.
I think it's three.
I want to say three. So for people, so let's bring. Exactly. So for those who don't know, back in the day, those redlining, where financial institutions were allowed to basically say, hey, we're not going to rent to people in this area, or we don't have to give loans to these people. So basically, that kind of created people had to choose to live only in certain locations, because if you want to live in a quote unquote good area or area with a high Caucasian population, then legally banks and other institutions could say, "Eh, no." Agents, real estate agents, could say, "Don't send people this way." So, 50 years later, there were like downstream impacts of that. So, in terms of people weren't allowed, that's basically what they're saying.
After that, because you had people like with the Black Renaissance was after that. So then you had
Renaissance,
the Black Renaissance.
Wait, are we talking about the same era?
No, I'm saying after that era, there were things where they were trying to make blocks and stopping people. So it was like one generation that wasn't even allowed to do it. Then the next generation had a hard time to do it. If they did do it, they were chopping them down. Mm-hmm. So they're saying because of that effect, that's why we have such a gap.
Yeah.
But our point of this is not to sit there and talk about or express, you know, what's holding us, what hold us down in the past, is to say that, hey, this is a new generation. This is a new way. We have a new way of thinking. We do have to understand our past, but yet we do have to understand, okay, how do we improve that as individuals, right? As people, as lower class, in my opinion, as broke people, how do we gain wealth? And as far as we know it, school is the only thing that can give us that wealth.
Right. Because we don't know about investments and hedge funds and, you know.
Shit, y'all don't. I know Lil's.
I was about to say, I don't know, man. I don't know, man.
But I didn't know what the heck a hedge fund was. Like,
so,
oh, for real?
So what? Okay, go ahead.
Go ahead, who?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know, man. Because I look at, like, rappers.
Oh, that's not. Entertainers. Remember I talked about that conversation?
And managers. Not just, like, so LeBron James's manager.
Is what color?
Is black. It's his best friend.
That's right.
Yeah.
The homie.
That's he didn't learn that from school.
You know how it goes.
He learned it because he had a commitment to his friend and he wasn't
But
dumb.
He didn't go to school?
Come on, man. You know how it is with the team.
LeBron James went to the NBA at 17.
Bro, let you be
manager.
President. Somehow,
how is he in school?
Let you be president. Somehow I'll be working in the White House. You know the drill, man. Look, we have the whole Welcome to the Wall podcast in the White House. Welcome to the White House.
That's true. That's true.
Oh, wow.
Hey, y'all be fucking up. I got to make a speech. Look. It's very unfortunate what happened, but hey, you know.
I'm just thinking about that Dave Chappelle one.
Which one?
Don't drop that yellow cake.
Don't you drop that.
It's going to be just like that. You just make a little speech, it blow over.
Oh, bitch.
But when you think about that, without LeBron being able to make that income, build that wealth, would he be able to put his homeboy on that way?
So, okay, so good example.
Opposite. He was his homeboy before he was wealthy. Like, he was his manager going into his signing his contract.
But if LeBron never became that wealthy guy, do you think that guy would have had that opportunity to be the guy that he is now?
I think we are downplaying how important that guy was.
He's very important.
Like, LeBron James is wealthy because that's his agent.
I mean, true.
/ manager.
But I'm saying, like, as far as...
well, I don't know if his agent. It's just kind of...
So if
opportunities that he would have had without... Yeah. Them like ever meeting. Let's say they didn't run into the lunchroom together or however they
said. I don't know that he would have the same opportunities.
That's what I'm saying.
I think he's as wealthy as he is in part because of his friend.
But so, if Obama was in the White House,
he has his best interest.
There's a lot of people who wouldn't have these opportunities that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So if. How do you build that? It's like that guy who's obviously smart, but there's no way he probably would have got to that point without. He probably could have.
Some
how
of
could
it,
he have done it, though?
Some of it is luck and opportunity. I don't know.
I mean, like, the reason I say rappers is because the new generation of rappers aren't so hell-bent on getting signed by labels and big corporations.
Right? But a lot of them are garbage, too.
But I mean, like, Chance still doesn't have a label. Drake, he went half his career without a label. Khalifa literally never had a label. Royce da 5'9" owns his own distribution.
Oh, yeah. Royce
He does. He's not with Shady Records.
Like he has a distribution warehouse.
Oh,
yeah.
Like somebody, he can distribute.
There's another guy that's
albums.
Been doing longer than that.
I mean, I get that, but So the original point is, you know, if you 17, 18, where the opportunity going to come from?
Well, I think...
So if you come from a broke family, you're walking down the street, you got an opportunity tree?
Rightfoot made a huge point, though.
Yeah.
We're talking about these new wealthy people, the ones that's in the spotlights, the ones we see, the ones that's really
like
making that
independent?
Wealth. These guys are not taking that traditional route that we're all being kind of trapped into, right? What they're doing, they're taking these people to these places, and just like LeBron James, homeboy, who probably would have went through the traditional route and been stuck. Instead, he was able to be in a higher position and grow and help build their career together.
That's the best school.
Movie production. You see what I'm saying?
You got the best superstar in the world. There's no school that can teach you how to be the manager of the best superstar in the world, like the superstar of the world.
Nope.
How did he find that? How did he know that he was going to be the greatest basketball player in the world? And why didn't he go to the traditional route like what we did? He didn't even go to college. He said, bump this, I'm going straight to the league. How did he know that he was so good?
He went to
the
league like LeBron. Hey, bro, we made it.
Right. So... he took a chance on himself or his homeboy or what they were building together, and they sat there and they made a commitment.
Yep.
The thing about this, what the question was asked to me, you know, is like, hey, I'm thinking about not going to school. Is school like the only way of going? I mean, is the only route to be to build wealth?
It's not
to be a mogul.
So here's the thing about school we didn't talk about. Half the thing with school is networking, and
which is very good,
and basically places. Work with schools, get access to the people in schools. So really, it's just about getting in contact with recruiters and your classmates.
Wait.
So like for the LeBron example, the opportunity and the network was there. We're going to go to the National Basketball Association.
Mm-hmm. So if
I study sports administration or whatever the shit is called, I would have access to maybe NBA something. Mm-hmm. But if I don't know the next face of the league, right. I gotta go to some goofy school and study sports management or something.
The top 99% are the ones that's going to these schools, right?
To study beautiful. Sports something.
And that's who we're speaking to because we are that 99%.
Okay, so... All right, go ahead.
So that 99%, most of us, maybe I would say 80% of us, maybe a little bit lower, are going straight to college.
Yeah.
Especially nowadays, right?
Because we don't have a LeBron.
Because we don't have a Bron.
All right, so let me ask you this.
We do have a Bron, but we don't have the people surrounding a Bron to take.
All right, so let me ask you then. So if you know, so if a dude is like 17, 18, hey, I'm trying to accomplish this, would you say find a team now? Or scout people? Or not even sports?
That's a good question.
Not even sports.
That's a good question.
Just say, hey, I got an idea for a website. Go try to find programmers and graphic designers now? I mean, what would you say?
I think now school is not for people that know what they want to do.
Straight up.
Like, if you know what you want to do coming out of high school, I don't think you need to go to
college. Okay, so how do you know what you want to do out of high school?
There are some people, so like, I'll bring up the example.
Because all dudes want to skeet in women.
That's true.
Not all dudes. There are a lot of programmers right now.
We are in Atlanta.
That's true. They skiing on the computer, but they ain't skiing on women.
Yeah, exactly.
And we in Atlanta. We take that in consideration, too.
They want to skeet on men. Whatever, man. They want to skeet.
They just skeet on that keyboard. Hey, when you press that D button, that thing take a long time to come back up. When you press that button, it just kind of sitting there for a little bit. Then it's like, all right, I'm ready.
A new keyboard costs like $20. They can buy a new keyboard.
On a laptop, though. And you're a college student.
Yeah,
you gotta check that browser. That. If you hit that thing and you hit you and only tube come up, you know something fishy. Bro.
Hey, when you look at that, when you look at their camera on their laptop and they got like it look like it got like tape around it, you know they just put tape over their little camera screen because they didn't want nobody to see them.
You already know the deal.
Nah, people be getting hacked. I thought, right?
Exactly. They get their video camera hacked. That's why they put tape over it, man.
Yeah, man.
Hey, tell about them hackers in the video. Hey, we're going to email this to everybody unless you give us $1,000.
$1,000. Then they got to call their parents.
I'll be like, email it, shit.
I'm like, hey, what was I watching? Go ahead. You know what
I mean. Gosh, that's hilarious. But you say if I'm 17, 18, I have an idea, I should
pursue it.
Why not?
Pursue it.
We have so many. This is the thing. Once upon a time, 20 years ago, they was able to keep us away from education. If you're broke, you couldn't learn shit, right? Mm-hmm. especially in the city schools, nobody teach you nothing. But now we have the World Wide Web and so many things that can teach you.
Internet.
You know that changed the game.
How many times do you guys Google a day? Question.
Like, oh, I Google every day.
Multiple times.
Like
every day.
Crazy, right?
So at least engine. Once or twice a day.
Do you? How many times do you guys go to a library or open up a book for like information?
What's a library?
Shit.
I go there to study, but
maybe
you go to the library to study. You don't even open the book.
I don't. Well, I mean, I open a book.
That's
what I'm saying.
I go to the internet because
they had them rooms with
me.
The door on it.
So
internet to teach.
Yeah. So unless you're in school, like to your campus has a library, probably not much.
So I got a better question.
Unless you need to go to the library to use the computer.
So did you guys learn more through school or through the internet?
In my case, the answer's still the internet.
Oh.
In my case, though. I can't say 100% what I knew what I wanted to do, so I think school was a good route.
Okay, that's me.
If you know what you want to do, I say you spend those 4 years getting good at it.
Mm. I can't. So for me, interning, the real life shit, I learned the most.
Yeah,
like
that's true.
Intern at a startup, I learned a lot about entrepreneurship.
But did you know what you wanted to do? Did you know you wanted to do that? That's what I'm saying. You had to think
about it. Not 100%.
And then you had to.
Know what they want to do.
But I didn't have to go to school, though. You know what I mean?
But you had to change. You changed your majors a few times to kind of figure out what you want to do.
That's what I'm saying. Like, the people that are like, look, this is what I want to do, I don't think they need college. Just like in Europe, I mean.
Well, see, no. I talked to a dude. I talk. One of my classmates is a German dude.
Super different.
And he's like, he doesn't. And the way they do it in Germany, at least.
They send them early.
Not even that. Like, apparently in the U.S., we're very major-centric. So if you study major X, that's you.
Yeah.
So in Germany, it's like, shit, you study business, you business. You don't have to be accounting, finance, just all this other bullshit. It's very general to give you the flexibility to still, you know, you're not stuck. Whereas
that's for
in
college. Like, isn't it like their primary schools?
I don't know.
More specific.
I didn't know which one he was talking about.
And they have more apprenticeship type things.
That's true. But I'm just saying, just in general, it seems like here in the States,
they're more skill based.
If you study some shit,
which is why they're so efficient.
That's you for the next 3-4 years.
Like it or not.
So, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying.
It's like you branded.
So check this out.
That's why I don't think it's for everybody.
It's definitely not.
Like, bro, you math. Like, I don't want to be an analyst.
So it's too bad, my dude. So check this out.
That's too bad.
So what you're doing to build wealth, this is what we looked up. Can you help me out with this? So most people with a regular 4-year degree, you're coming out with $30,000. That's $30,000, right?
Most degrees.
Salary.
Most degrees.
Base salary.
The only degree that's more than that is what?
The engineering.
And how much is engineering when you come out?
About 50.
So that means the rest of the people, if you want to make more than $30,000, you more than likely have to go to master's.
Yes.
How many people that we know got a bachelor's degree in something other than engineering and had to go back to school and get their master's?
Everybody.
A lot of motherfuckers. Yeah. Right? Psychology.
Yes.
Right?
Political
science.
Yes.
Right? What was the degree you had? Criminal justice.
You don't even remember.
Right? Mathematics. Physics.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't really matter what you do. You're kind of locked into having to get your master's. Mm-hmm. All ripped.
Unfortunately.
So check this out. After getting the average debt coming out of college is $30,000. The average.
So that's about the price tag
with
$30,000.
Oh, my God.
That's the average. That means you coming out making, owing what you're going to make.
Basically.
So do you guys know what compound interest is?
I was about to say, and it's not going to be $30,000.
Right.
By the time you end up paying, it's going to be like $60,000.
It's going to be double.
You're
going to
be paying that bare minimum in the beginning.
Like, I'm not going to lie. I just figured out, if I was smart, how I'll use my undergrad, like, this week. Like, I seen some dudes. I went to an event Monday, and I seen some people talk about, they were talking about the election and blah, blah, blah. And the people on stage were these guys who dealt with policy. So I never thought about it. And I'm saying this is how dumb I am in terms of using what I originally went to school for. And I thought it was really cool. So when you go to the when you vote this election, they have these things on a ballot box. So vote for this thing
And they got these people who have to drive the campaign. So these people hire these policy dudes to say, hey, we want to pass this, you know, get it done. So when you see the commercials, when you get shit in the mail, there's a business basically behind it. That's like, hey, vote for this reason, or they work with different political groups, and you know.
Yeah, we had somebody come by the house recently promoting Amendment 1.
You know, what I'm saying? And
well, the referenda one.
Yeah, so they go hard body. So it's just there's a lot of shit that goes into policy that I didn't think about in terms of just how to get shit done. So in the Atlanta area, I think in 2015, 2014, mm-hmm. there was the dude who did the Clayton County MARTA expansion. MARTA, the transit system for Atlanta. He was there in terms of how to get that done and the shit that goes into it. So I was like, oh. He's basically a consultant. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, okay, that's how you would use policy in terms of having a decent job versus some bullshit you don't know how to even use a degree. You know what I mean? So is when you have like a non-engineering degree, mm-hmm.
yeah,
and you don't really understand how to best maximize your potential, you're gonna be fucked. You fucked up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, you just because
you pick some shit and it's like, it's cool, it's interesting, but how can you apply what jobs are out there for that? You know mm-hmm. what I mean?
I mean, that's, you don't get that from school. Not how to apply it.
That's my point. So, yeah.
That's why I say, if you know what you want to do, I don't see why you need to go to school.
Yeah.
Engineering?
Makes sense. Or at least an apprenticeship, at least.
Yeah, yeah.
You got to have that, like, work underneath, like, engineer now.
Engineering is a little different. That's why I said, like, I think my path that I chose was correct. But for everybody, like, a computer science, if you're good, you're good. It used to be most people, they were good. The best people in the class, they were good, were there just to get validation. Now, you don't need it as much. I mean,
you can.
The internet's so prominent, and like, it's easy to see somebody's skill. That
you know how to develop, you have a portfolio.
I mean, they're getting like little kids to be
build websites.
What they were paying other people $80,000 a year to do, like grown adults.
Hey, you remember, you know how they used to have them sweatshops for kids?
They still got them guys.
They're going to have new sweatshops where it's like computers.
They actually have that.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
So wait a minute.
How?
What do you mean? They just got like kids that are really good.
So they got kid programmer sweatshops?
They program, yeah.
So
they got 14-year-old hackers that can hack into the government.
No, fuck that. We want to have 8-year-olds. So
all right. So you know, like those click sites. Like there's just people to get you views.
Yeah.
It's like whole buildings in like India where there's just a bunch of kids. That's all they do. And they're just like.
So wait, if we have ideas.
They have gaming too. It's crazy.
How much do we need to pay these motherfuckers to build us some shit?
No. They're not going to take your money because they're going to hack your stuff. These guys are only designed to hack your stuff.
What do you. Like design?
China,
like,
Russia.
Like the
China, Russia.
They like develop. And North Korea.
Wait,
and
you mean like
kids?
Design
kids.
Like
China,
like
Russia, North Korea, and there's another place.
So
too.
Wait, the Matrix.
China, Russia.
So the kids come out of like little eggs.
Yes.
And they pop up. connected to the computer.
I saw.
It's crazy.
I saw it on 60 Minutes when they talked about it.
It's crazy.
It is like.
So what is it called?
It's called hacking.
They don't. They have
no
like
term.
A name. For
you
like,
talk about baby hacker.
Yeah. These
kids are like eight. Like real talk.
8 years old.
Like getting government documents.
By the 12 or like 16. 13, these guys are hacking government. These are like
governments. That's their job, like to hack government.
So they don't have childhoods.
It's not
no.
like this is. Come on, they're
stealing from their parents.
They're supporting their family.
Like they'll take, like say you have a school test, and then you know like the highest graded, like the highest scoring kids.
Yeah,
they just scooping kids up. Never see them again.
Oh, for real?
Or that kid is being sent off to take care of the family. It's like soccer players or like from other those poor countries.
Oh, China used to do that with the Olympics. I know y'all noticed how them gymnastics people look like they were 10 years old.
They get them young.
Because they were really like 10 years old.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
I don't
like
think
they go to farms and then they like take kids and they put them in like Olympic.
I'm not lying, bro.
It's a game.
They take them to Olympic camps and then all they do is just athletics.
All I'm saying.
And then when they're done.
So wait.
They're poor.
So wait. I'm a family. The kid be out playing,
and
a van show up, and they snatch up the kid.
Yeah,
sometimes depending on the country, and the or some of them they pay the family, so the family's like, hey, do good. So, I think it's like China, do good,
because
the population's so great,
family.
And we'll support your family. So regardless,
do good.
Like, the game is... I don't think y'all understand what's going to happen.
Like,
y'all.
It's super
These
serious.
Hackers are going to be messing us up in the future.
If they that's what they're going to be like the new Cold War.
It's internet security. Like, I don't think we laughing and joking. We depend on the internet so much.
Yeah.
Right? Which...
Oh, what if that shit... What if they leaked your email?
What if they just turn that bitch off? When you go to the internet and that bitch just say off?
No, it's not going to say that. It's going to say LOL. They're
going to be like, LOL, gotcha. They gonna be like
smiley face.
You gonna try to go on that porn site? You'll be like, LOL.
You can't beat your meat today, my dude. Like,
and then you gonna start googling real stuff. Why is the internet down?
Yeah. LOL.
LOL. Bro, people will go crazy. It's gonna be like The Walking Dead, right?
It is.
Instead of zombies, we're gonna be like just dumb. So we're not gonna be regular.
We can't. We can't reverse hack if they kids. We can't reverse hack them with Magic School Bus.
I don't think you understand how
he doesn't get it, man.
I don't get it.
Do you know how complicated computers are now? Have you ever made an app?
That's
the
not
app
our
is
area
the
of expertise.
Thing.
Yeah.
The app is probably the easiest thing to make.
Yeah.
These kids are making this thing at 8 years old. Do you know how to make an app?
Nah.
8 year old know, 8 year old know more about computers than you, bro. A lot more.
Oh, for
Me
real?
Too. Yeah. He thinks we joking, bro.
How many bytes are in a bit?
1,000.
100.
Oh, gosh.
Is it 1,000?
First of all, there's no bytes.
No. What's the
so
there's no bytes and bits?
So it's you have a byte and a byte has 4 bits. Am I correct? So there's it's, 4 bits in a byte.
And it's a 1,000 bytes in a megabyte. Yeah.
There's 1,000 bytes in a megabyte.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a megabyte.
I thought it was
And, okay, so I know that. And then 1,000
I thought it was goddamn 27.
Like 8 bits in a byte?
I thought it was eight. It's 8 bits in a byte. I'm tripping.
4 bytes in a nibble.
In a nibble, right.
What the fuck?
It's a subcategory.
It's crazy.
Do you see what we're talking about?
That's no idea. These kids are known as early. So, yeah.
And it's 8 year old.
I'm tripping. So, I messed up.
Wait. What's a nibble?
A nibble is a little bite. So, instead of...
It's a big bite.
What?
Nibble's 4 bites. Right?
Oh, we get hacked.
We get hacked tonight.
Oh, remember, see?
They're going to hack our podcast.
Wait. So what's the scale?
Number one podcast.
What's the smallest? What's the smallest? Bit. The bit? Okay. Yeah. And then above the bit is what?
Oh, is a nibble, and that's 8. That's 8 bytes.
That's 4. I thought it was 4 bytes.
Then
so how many?
Because it's megabyte, then gigabyte, and then terabyte.
That's what I was thinking. I thought a nibble was 8 bits.
Because we still want some.
No. The tera is just. How many you can have right. Terabits?
Just the fact that we have to go through all this just shows you we are in trouble. We are.
That's what I'm saying. There's 8 year olds that looking at us like these dumbasses over here arguing
we're not
about
seeing
some
this
shit.
Every
it's
day.
So easy.
It's so, the language is so you have to speak this thing.
Yeah,
fluently.
A byte
you take it
is
for
8
bits.
Yeah, a byte is 8
okay,
bits.
Go ahead.
And then
nibble
a
is
nibble
is 4.
Yeah, a nibble is 4
and
bytes.
A nibble is 4 bits. Just like a byte is a big byte and
a
nibble is a little.
Is 4 bytes.
4 bytes. Yes, a nibble is 4 bytes.
And that's why aren't they called mega nibbles instead?
That sounds stupid.
Because you sound goofy
nibbles.
Like
that
you just
sound do. Stupid.
So that's what it is, though, right?
No, it's not.
No.
When you eat your
you
oatmeal, you're not doing nibbles.
You just made something up and thought it sounded good.
No, y'all said nibbles, and
no,
I'm
no,
like, what
this
the
out.
Fuck?
When you eat your oatmeal, do you do a nipple or do you do a regular bite?
We ain't talking about nipples.
And that also sounds like an HR situation. Hey, you happy to mega nipple?
That's going to get you called in the HR room?
Yeah.
See, that's why people get hacked. You see?
Mega nibbles.
We joking.
Giga nibbles.
It's all for the game. So
it's
you
all
get
all
it.
Two nibbles.
One bite?
That's what I'm saying. It's a mega. A nibble is 4 bits. A bite is
wait,
8 bits.
A nibble is 16 bits. Because
oh.
A bit is 8 bits is 1 bite.
That shit's stupid.
It is stupid.
See, that's
it's not like so cereal on Kellogg's,
but that's what we're talking about.
It's been a while, and that's why we're
that's a good one.
Hacked.
Two nibbles, 1 bite, cereal.
Keep playing around.
It's not like cereal.
If y'all don't understand what these nibbles and these bites do, y'all ain't seen
part
no
of a balance
back.
So, bang,
part
bang.
Of a balance
you
bang
ain't
for
bit no nibbles.
So, wait,
no
you
nibbles.
Won't get no bites.
So, what bang bang? If I don't know what a nibble is, I'm gonna hack.
You ain't gonna get, if you don't know what a nibble is, you ain't gonna see no nipples, my dude. Check this out. That's for a fact. We're going to get hacked, and they're going to shut down the internet. And every time we hit the site, it's going to say LOL, like you said.
How are they going to shut down the internet?
They're going to say www, and you're going
to. You know what? I'm going to go to what's that place called in Gwinnett Micro Center? I'm going to ask
it's
them for a tetra nibble.
Y'all better learn how to farm. Y'all better learn how to farm. Y'all better learn how to read the stars. Because after that internet
so
what, shut down.
I gotta know how to go north.
You gotta know how to go north.
North Star.
To Canada.
I want to go to Canada.
It's the only place
he's going to Canada.
I want
to
go south.
Because he like his mocha right, with the white chocolate.
To. I want to go south where it's hot.
I ain't going to take
Mexico.
I can't drink the water, bro. I can't do that.
Oh, yeah, damn.
So my thing is this. We are way out of the loop. If you want to be in the field right now, something involved with internet security, or internet safety, internet.
And make sure you mention the nibbles.
Nah, I can't.
And that's about it.
Kids are smarter.
That was
you know why they're smarter?
Was that?
They have to worry about less.
They're young. Yeah. They don't have nothing to think about.
They have to know less.
They don't even know what nipples are.
They can focus more on other things.
They be getting kidnapped. I might be focused too if I'm kidnapped.
I don't know. I'll be scared. Somebody put a gun in my head. I can't concentrate.
So, baby, you kidnapped.
Hack that site. I ain't hacking that site. I'm going to kill your mama. Oh, okay, that's right. Shit. I'm hacking the hell out of this.
Yeah.
Q. On it. P.
So how do you hack something? You just type in numbers?
It's not Matrix. See, that's why you're going to get hacked.
That's exactly what we're talking about.
So what, you type in nibbles?
You're going to be the one putting your credit card information on fake sites.
You exploit the weaknesses. Some sites have weaknesses, so... You might run a script, inject some malware into it. Most people do the email that just say, hey.
Mm-mm. No, man, I'm telling you, it's a fake site.
It's old game.
They don't make a site that looks just like a normal site. Yep. Put all your shit in.
Oh, you talking about.
I don't think you understand. You think about the times when they had like chat rooms.
Yeah, bro.
That's a whole different game, my dude.
So
it's crazy.
You're going to get hacked in so many different ways. It's bad, bro. It's like when those people were stealing credit card identities, right? When you slide your credit card into a little slot thing, and they'll put like little fake slots.
Man, you just gotta go to the same websites.
That's what gets you messed up.
It's like a credit hole. It's not the right site. It's the wrong slot.
You know who they got in charge of like security system for your favorite sites?
What's that?
They got Barbados in charge of internet security.
Wait, what? Excuse me? Ain't nobody gonna get us.
She be like, who hacking us?
Hey, somebody so bang us? Bang. How's the meeting go? What they do? Hey, so what's the status update?
What's this? So I'm bang bang. Everybody be like, good morning, baby.
So
Barbados, what is the status on our current internet?
We got 50 nibble bites, and we got.
I don't mean that thing like, okay, nibble bites? Because I ain't gonna know nothing either. I'll be like, you said 50 nibble bites?
What is that?
That's a whole watermelon. That's a whole pie.
We got 50 nibble bites coming in for us in the email system.
Is that good?
I don't even know what
is
they
that
say.
Is that good or bad?
Who's nibble biting us? Is there ice involved?
ISIS.
I'm shutting down the site and you're getting fired tonight.
Oh, wait. Bang,
bang. Tonight?
Bang, bang. No, shut it down like Diddy shut down the studio. And what's that show?
Making the band.
Making the band.
I don't know how to shut it down. How you shut it down?
He'd be like, shut down the site.
Hey, y'all. I'm shutting down the site tonight.
No. Here go.
You ain't doing it right.
So wait. You know the internet security? That's what we doing now? We got nibble bites.
Oh, so you over here nibble biting.
So we didn't even know who hacking us? We didn't even know?
I mean, they're not biting my nipples. They're biting your nipples.
So, that's okay. My nipples get... It's shutting down the site. It's shutting down the site. Everybody fight.
I'm not opening this site back up.
Until you give me some...
Until you
breast
can
milk.
Find me some...
what did he say? Cambodian breast milk?
Some Cambodian nibble bites.
No. And find me... Find me a 10-year-old that can hack so we can reverse hack them back.
Alrighty.
You gotta give me that by 5:00. Mm. Are you kicked out the
See y'all in real big trouble, my dude. We just opened up a can of worms on that app. But in the meantime, that might happen when we old and don't even care about internet no more.
You're right, because I'm gonna have my video games and that's about it.
So the system gonna get hacked.
Then you want my Xbox games? That don't need internet?
You're going to keep it offline?
Xbox 100% got hacked. Everybody know that.
Xbox 360?
It's stupid, yeah.
Right. Xbox.
So
Xbox.
Let's get back on topic.
I'm still
man.
Have them, though.
So, oh, they What's say... So let's say, for example, you graduate a degree. You say, bump this. I'm tired of school because you didn't graduate school in the 4 years like you were supposed to, right? You went ahead and graduated in like maybe 5-6 years.
Right.
So you accumulated more debt, but we're not going to go to that far. We're going to say that your job is $30,000 and you owe $30,000, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So the average interest rate is 6%, right?
Oof. About, yeah.
Oof. So can you go into the details about that? Actually. Oof.
Okay, so, you know, let's say, like Bang Bang said, you have a $30,000 job mm-hmm. that you make a year, and you have $30,000 in debt that right, you right, right. are paying on. So if you have a paycheck, $30,000 paycheck,
right,
and before taxes, mm-hmm. and you dedicate a percentage of that.
I'm eating on the mic, my bad.
And you dedicate a percentage of that paycheck every month to pay back your student loan. Now, mm-hmm. typically, I don't know what y'all's situation looks like, but I can't afford over 8% of that $30,000 check
okay.
per month, which is typical after taxes. So that's about $200.
And what's the minimum like required that they ask for?
I think the minimum that they require is like 150.
1%?
No.
1-3% is like the minimum of your debt that you
require. I don't know.
Monthly.
See,
monthly?
Yeah, monthly is like a minimum of 1%. So they take 1% of that. That's how they get you locked in.
Well, yeah, yeah.
1-3%, and then you pay that minimum, but you're paying all your money to the interest. Mm-hmm. So,
and the so interest is basically, compounded daily.
So basically, let's say you took 8%.
Every day is compounded.
Let's say you took 8%. You know, just throwing it out there, $200 a month you're paying on your student loans. So it would technically take you 23 years and 2 months to pay back that loan, and you will pay more than $25,000 in interest. So you're actually paying up to $60,000 for a degree that only got you a $30,000 job to begin with, mm-hmm. and over 23 years
to pay that back.
Yeah, you have to pay that back, and you're paying double in interest.
So how much was the interest?
So the interest is 6%.
I'm saying how much you paid in interest.
$25K.
So you got a $30,000 K loan and you pay back $25K in interest in over 23 years if you pay the minimum.
If you pay $200 a month.
$200 a month.
Just on look, your yeah, move back with your moms.
And that's not including the house loan that you may have or the car loan pay that you may have or credit card bills.
Or
you may
or the clothes you had to buy back after you broke up with your girlfriend and she burned all your clothes.
All right, what are we talking about?
Too many nipple bites.
So we know that it's very expensive to go to college. If you take out a loan, it's going to be double that. So what happens? How can you be successful in school? Before I make that point,
yeah.
For an FYI,
yeah,
40%. So this is 100% of us going to school. 40% is a 40% dropout rate, right?
You said 4-0.
4-0.
So from school, it's a 40% dropout.
And I'm pretty sure most of that percentage happens within the first year when people party and they drop out
now,
in their freshman
year.
We took
a very tough degree. So I knew a lot of people who dropped out before. I think we all knew.
Mm-hmm. There's some changing majors.
A lot of times, right? So there's a 40% dropout. So for the 60%, we're mm-hmm. talking about how can you be successful in college for the 60% that make it all the way through?
Mm-hmm.
Stable.
For college graduates.
You gotta have some stability. I know that fucked me up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
If I had a little bit more stability at home, that would have been nice.
Dang.
Well, okay, yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would have been. Looking back, there was some nonsense going on.
Do you
on.
Think like the dorms would have been a good option?
I would have loved staying on campus.
How expensive would you think it would have been?
I would have.
You could look it up.
Yeah, like a good 20 flat.
No,
should be like an extra 5,000 a semester. Or
yeah, a semester though. So if you're doing what, maybe I think how many semesters? It's a lot.
Two.
Yeah, if I did 2 years, yeah,
it would have been up there. Just having to spend that extra money, so
well, it might have paid for eight over yeah. a year.
But I'm saying the benefit of that, you on campus, you eating.
It's an experience. I'm not
yeah,
gonna lie.
You
your freshman year,
chilling. There's just
I loved it.
You get to yeah.
So
I didn't get to have that experience.
What happens if people like are just trying to, figure out like what's the best way to be like, as far as like how to study, grades, like what was like one keys you say just to be successful in school, period. Like, is there anything you should do while you're in school? Is there anything you should do before you go to school or after school? Like,
know what you want to do. And if you don't know, don't commit to anything.
Because, you know, I have a friend and she went to school the same time I did. We all started the same year, 2008. I think she changed her major about 3 times.
Okay, that's average. And I'm playing.
In undergrad. All I say is God damn it. She changed it 3 times, and she did it like with a year between each change. So a lot of her classes she had to rebound and, you know, take over. And she ended up graduating from 2008 all the way to 2015. So that's about a good 7 years that she was in college. Just from changing her majors so many times, she ended up spending, I don't even want to know how much she ended up owing in financial aid. I don't even want to know. 7 years in school.
Dang. I mean, but that's, the average is five to six years because stuff like that.
And, you know, she, it was a lot of stuff in between that. So she finally graduated, yes. Yeah. But I'm pretty sure she's going to hold off on grad school. And I'm pretty sure I'm pretty sure she's gonna need grad school now,
but she
with her major.
Did she actually graduate what she wanted to do in like what she graduated? Is that what she wanted to do? Or she
I guess so. I guess that's what she wanted to do.
I forgot to mention this.
Get about that thing.
You got it. So we'll talk about if you have a degree, you're not satisfied, you want to change careers. There's a lot of people doing the thing, just coding boot camps. Where you learn a new language in like a couple of weeks.
So,
and they're developers and they're making buku.
So, for that 40%, so the 40% that doesn't make it through.
That's what I'm saying. So
is that advice that you give to them?
It's like if you're studying computer science and you say, man, fuck that, you can still go to the booty camp.
A booty camp?
Wow.
Not the booty camp.
Oh, what's on your mind, bro?
Bro, you spending more money at the booty camp.
No. coding, nah. Coding boot camp.
Okay. Yeah, okay. I was about to say, what is this booty camp that you speak of?
Code boot camp or whatever it's called.
Okay.
And you just learn the hottest or the new stuff that's in demand.
That's why I said, if you know what you want to do, you don't
need to. Yeah, so for example, machine learning, predictive analytics, Ruby Rails, there's all the shit you can learn.
Ruby Rails on there.
So, what advice would you give that 40%, that the ones that just dropped out? Is it like
learn a skill? Yeah, because we talked about it. It's like while you undergrad, be a barber or electrician,
cutting hair.
Yeah,
have a side hustle. Anything that can off balance all of that debt.
Okay. So then you guys will say a trade might be a good look.
Absolutely.
Oh yeah.
But why? But
that's why I don't think you should go to school.
But wait. So in was going to trade cool? Because everybody talked bad about JUCO college, but damn, you had to be dumb or slow to have to go to a trade school.
Looking back, knowing plumbing or HVAC is pretty valuable now.
Hell yeah.
If your AC go out, what you going to do? You going to have no AC?
What if your name is Lakeisha and you want to do hair? You think doing hair will make sense or nah?
You got to do hair while you do some other shit too.
So you mean get a trade, then go back to school?
You do not.
I think so.
Okay.
But why would you go back to school just to get a business degree?
Because the thing is, isn't there like a cap with trade degrees? Like you can only make so much
because the person
with the degree is going to get the higher job than you, which sucks about the job market. We know there's people who's qualified, but they don't have the quote unquote credentials.
Yeah. So it's just kind of like, if I want to be a lawyer, I could just sit up and I'm going to just go to school with no experience. Or while I'm going to school, I work for the courthouse or do something. I'm just not going to – you just don't depend on just school. You build some paralegal skill set or do some shit. So then when you get out that bit, you combine it and you say, bam.
Yeah, it's kind of like the statement, faith without works is dead. So if you go to school with no – and you just don't work and you have no experience and you didn't get anything from it, I mean, what did you get a degree for? It's
just not worth it. Sometimes for networking and just
– even if you didn't do that. Sometimes people don't network when they go to school.
For real?
Some people come out of college. Most people don't do it. I think we know somebody who went to college and
didn't do nothing.
They didn't really somebody do I much.
I super network. Plural. So don't look at me.
I'm not talking about you.
Oh, I like a super network.
I'm about to say, look, if you go to school,
you better network the sh out there.
Look, you got
to
join organizations, mm-hmm. do make good grades, mm-hmm. or skeet on people,
or skeet on them teachers.
Ain't look, nobody skeet. Gotta, no, skeet there is no skeet involved.
Right. What? You tripping?
Skeet on that paper. You better skeet on something. That means something. You like it enough to skeet on it. You know how much you gotta like something to skeet on. You know what I'm saying? Skeet. This doesn't come easy.
I don't think you gotta like it that much.
All right. So that's another topic. So the thing is, in order for you to like something, you have to work for it, right?
Mm-hmm. Sometimes.
Sometimes, right? So I mean, you gotta hustle. If you like something, you get in touch with the people. You try to get in those groups that like that stuff because they're doing the things that you like to do, yeah. right? You build friends that way.
Yeah, LinkedIn.
It's why would you go to school for the piece of paper? Because you're not just paying for that. You're
well, like you said before, some people, they didn't know or have the knowledge. Somebody just told them, go to school.
Look, end of the day, you interview. Mm-hmm. All right, what makes you different than everyone else? Why should we hire you? What you going to say? If you just in that, if all you did was just go to class and go home, join no organization, did no extra shit. You should hire me because I am good.
I went to booty camp.
I went to booty.
Well, a lot of people's resumes look like that, unfortunately. A lot of people didn't take advantage of undergrad opportunities.
No.
Like they should have.
And not
they
want to
do it.
You want to know how you want to separate yourself? If you go to school, if you're that 60%, mm-hmm. you'd be like, hey, I did a project on the thing that
some
I want
side
to do.
Shit,
some
yeah.
side stuff, right?
That take
right.
some initiative. I actually did that. Do something yourself. And the other thing is, salary negotiation. So they give you the
that's
job.
That's too deep, though. We got to do a whole thing on that. Yeah. But right. people got to, okay. that's a deep, that's a.
Yeah, that's the next.
You got to build, you got
to
build a
but
portfolio.
I guess I'm just saying, set yourself up so when you get to the job offer, you can say.
No worries.
But see, those people are a different breed. We're not talking about those people.
Yeah,
those
they
people
already
know what
be
they want to do. We're talking about the people that don't know what they want.
Who messing up in this world. We trying to save them. Captain save them all. So for that 40%.
Yeah.
Just so you know, although it may seem daunting that all your friends are graduating college, just so you know, they're paying probably double what their degree is actually worth,
mm-hmm.
right? Just to pay that thing back.
Pay that thing
also, they're
back.
Not making any money within that 4 to 6 years they're in college, FYI, right? No.
Yeah,
so
they're not making any
if you use
money.
A pickup a trade, which takes 2 years, right, mm-hmm. you'll be making money. It's not a hard degree. You'll be making money that whole what, since they're in school, that whole 4 years while they're in school.
And you can probably pay your way, no debt.
So we looked it up. We said because trade school takes two years versus the 4 years or more, with the trade, you can start working right away, mm-hmm. start building an income,
mm-hmm.
and they did like an average of 70?
Yeah, so you can get like a $70,000 head start on those who are still in college waiting on their bachelor's.
Because you're in college, you're not making any money, you're building debt. Mm-hmm. Where's your wealth at?
Because
we're
nonsense.
Talking about wealth. So
it's bullshit.
You're building a trade, something that you can actually use and do by yourself one day.
That's another thing we didn't talk about with school.
Ownership.
Here's the other thing about school. Who becomes teachers? Professors.
People who couldn't figure out what they want to do in life.
I'm telling you, man.
You know what I mean? I mean, it's weird.
So it's like, there's two sides of this.
I have a good example of that.
Go ahead.
My professor, no names, shall be named.
We got shade.
One of my past professors.
Way in the past.
Okay.
Not
this
now.
Particular individual worked for.
Don't say the company. Just say what they.
It's pretty general. It's for the government.
Skeet camp.
Okay. All right. That's okay.
So I don't know if you guys know what OPB is, but that's what it is.
OPP.
We know what OPP.
Well, yeah, this person
you know
knows
me.
Who they are.
OPB. So
they definitely know who they are.
Apparently, from what I hear, it's a place that
allegedly
a place. Allegedly, I hear it's a place that's a rotating door.
Oh,
that's a lot
but,
of places. So that's
yeah.
fair.
Revolving.
That's fair.
Let's use big college words here. Rotating door. What the hell is that? Revolving. Let's get the facts.
Why don't you
right.
revolve around? No. So
that's made me think of a video game. You got to go through the door. That bitch is rotating.
So anyway, y'all saw sidetrack. So anyway, this person worked there, and apparently it's a big deal to get on there. It's uh-huh. a great place. Mostly the people that go there stay there forever.
Okay. Mm.
Because it's a government job.
It's like, oh.
Anyway. So,
is it prison?
No. Oh. So y'all look it up. So anyway, this person worked there for a number of years doing different analysis.
I just got hacked.
Whatever.
I can't look it up.
So now this person is a professor, and now, this person never told the class mm-hmm. that they worked there, which would have been a huge deal seeing that the class that they're teaching has everything to do with government.
So what's the motivation of that person being a professor, do you think?
I think something happened. Something didn't work out.
Sexual harassment.
That's what I was thinking. He tried to skeet on somebody. She was like,
I don't know what happened. All I know is this person person is not the best professor that I've encountered. But
Okay.
And I can see that something happened and that this was not their intention firsthand. Like, this is not what they wanted in the beginning.
So are you saying our teachers don't want to teach us? They just have to teach us?
Some of them. They say, I can't deal with the private sector. Too stressful. And this is safer and easier.
So I'm paying $30,000 for a person who has to be there because they just went ahead and finished it?
Not everybody.
That is some bullshit.
So look, here's another thing too. So, think about how much money is going to people at the top. Mm-hmm. College presidents make a lot now. Not even that. Sport team, like colleges would get.
So wait.
Football
so
teams, they're the making, coaches make like $6 million.
So they're making more money, but we're paying more money?
Yeah, basically. And another thing. That's
crazy.
Yeah.
Is would you agree or disagree? A university's a career graveyard.
Dun, 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 dun.
I mean, yeah. Of course. How many people that we knew in school was like, you know what, man, I just want to go ahead and be a professor?
So,
because they don't make enough money.
So, look, here's the thing. If I say, all right, I'm paying for this shit, I want to get a good education. The thing is, the school can be like, our rankings are based on research. So, if you're smart and do good research, write papers, that helps us. But writing a paper and being a professor is not the same thing. So they can be a shitty teacher.
So you still get right.
Yeah.
But they'd be like super, super smart.
Mm-hmm. Basically.
And awkward.
I know one.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the motherfucker be like, you know, I invented computers. I invented Nibble Bytes.
I am a computer.
Yeah, he teleported in classroom. I'm a computer.
I am a computer.
And then he'd be like, so, you know, bam, make a computer. That's the time. He's like, with what? And then he just disappeared. He'd be like,
talk to my TAs, and all the TAs
like a
come
genius.
Around.
Oh, we didn't even talk about that.
Little microwaves. They're not even computers, they microwaves.
No, we didn't even talk about the folks who, you know how some classes, they got
like you're not even a whole computer. You a calculator. Oh, the piece.
Yeah. You know how the teaching assistants to be teaching? He'd be like, motherfucker, you're not even a real professor. But it'd be like the grad students who have to teach. They'd be like,
but they'd be so intense. Y'all got to study more. Y'all got to do
like,
better. Y'all work
fuck
on
fuck you. You're like the substitute teacher.
I can't
You're not real.
You're not real.
You're not real.
So you need to tell me y'all getting y'all not getting taught by real teachers?
No, I'm talking about undergrads. Like, remember some undergrads was like
we
didn't
have that.
Getting taught by master's students.
Not in our school.
We had to have a master's to have been taught by
They're PhDs teaching undergrads.
Yeah, we didn't have the master's.
Yeah, they have. Yeah.
We just got the master's program.
So it seems like it feels like a joke. It seems like getting a trade might be a good move because you can make money anytime.
Shit, yeah.
You know, when I was a college student, I had to work at like retail.
Some bullshit.
And I had to be customer service, and people cussed at me, told me stupid. And I was like, I'm in college. They're like, whatever.
So?
You're not going to make it. 40%. And I was like, oh man, not cool, bro. But I wasn't getting paid nothing. Maybe if I would have got a trade, maybe those 2 years might have been worth more than those little funky 4 years I spent at my little retail
job. No guidance.
Part time.
No guidance.
Yeah, well, you didn't know.
I didn't know. So why did I go to a place that I didn't know anything about? That's boo boo. That's why it makes sense to say the earlier you start, I feel like our counterparts or the people that was more successful, they start a lot earlier when they do these things.
Yeah. I think they just knew they wanted to do. Exactly.
So, I guess the point that I'm trying to make, let me go to your Instagram real quick and pull up that article that you sent me. Oh, it's GroupMe. Go to your GroupMe real quick. So, just to wrap this topic up for all the ones that know something. Well, you taking too long, man. I'm trying to show
you. Oh, wait.
Something.
Cleveland Indians won.
Okay.
So, does LeBron James get credit?
He gets no credit for that.
The Cavaliers won. He I think he gets credit.
Say what?
I keep chewing on this mic. Why does he get credit for the Cavaliers? I mean, for the Indians.
The Cavaliers inspired the Cleveland Indians to get to the World Series.
They definitely inspired them. They just definitely just won by themselves.
Well, quickly before we wrap it up, like, if y'all were to... What?
No, we're going to headlines.
Well, I just want to ask a question.
Okay.
Dang, what's the question, cuz?
So, like, if y'all were, like, to do it all over again, like, before undergrad, that's a good question. Like, what would you have done differently?
For the people who, like, don't know what to do.
I would do the same thing I did. Like I said, what I did in a short amount of time. But I would do the same.
Man, I would have found a sugar mama and got a trade.
Wait, so what did you guys do? So, like, for people who don't know exactly what you guys did, like.
I went to undergrad.
What's like, the move that you're happy with?
Shit, minimizing that debt for real, for real. Go to community college.
Community college.
Oh yeah, I didn't take that path. I took the stupid path. So.
Yeah, I took the stupid path too. Woo. Stupid.
Live at home as long as you can. Try to, if you can't live at home, live with friends close to campus as possible.
I just say, go to the university that you can afford.
Period.
With the small text. Make sure that thing's in state.
In state. At least, yeah. No out-of-state tuition in this thing.
Nah.
No out-of-state.
Unless you get a scholarship to make it in-state price, nah.
But the other thing, too, looking back, it starts in high school. Mm-hmm. If you set yourself up in high school, when you apply to college, you're good. You can set yourself up to get 4-year full ride. But how many when you 15, 16, you're not thinking about that
shit.
You
don't think about
that. You skipping class.
You got boyfriends.
You got boyfriends. I don't got.
This shit got weird.
That fuck up your mind. But anyway. Anyway.
But so, you know, competitions you can be doing in high school. You be doing a lot of shit in high school to set yourself up for when you apply to college.
Yeah.
Shit. Fuck regular school. Apply for Ivy League.
That's real.
Yeah. Try.
I don't know about that. Because you got to have a scholarship for that.
I would. That's what I would.
I'm going to keep it real skin. Ivy League. I ain't built for that. Ivy League.
Well, if I were to do it again, I would definitely do the 2-year school thing, work, and then go back and finish my 4-year. Yeah. And then if I like it, then I, you know, go back and get my master's.
Yeah. I wouldn't have did that, though.
I'm going to be honest. I'm going to be honest with you.
Yeah.
If I had the opportunity to go to Ivy League, I'd be like, yeah, definitely I go to Ivy League. These nuts. Because it's a waste of time. If I was built for that, then I would go to that.
So what? You don't want to network with the world leaders' daughters and sons?
Yeah, guess what I'm saying? Boo. Check this out.
You're tripping.
Okay. I would love to network.
It isn't like that.
But I think it's their field. It doesn't matter with them. Because they don't talk to each other anyway. They talk to computers all day. They talk to computers all day. They don't have a social life.
So you're going to be like that professor? You're going to be a computer?
Yeah, I'll be a computer. Check this out. You going to go. I'm out of high school.
You're antisocial.
Antisocial D's. You want to go? You want to come out of high school? Are you ready to go to NBA?
Nope.
If you Kobe, if you LeBron,
if I ain't Kobe, why are we going to these Ivy League schools? If I'm not Ivy League material,
you don't think so?
I ain't come from the streets. Ain't there's no way I could have been.
So what?
No
you go to Harvard? You gonna fight?
I ain't going to Harvard.
You gonna fight?
I'm going to Harvard D's. I ain't going nowhere. So that's gonna require me to work harder than I'm used to. That doesn't make any sense. I ain't went to no private school. Tell them nigga private D's. Look, I'm talking about the regular smegular. 80% of us, they don't know what's going on in this space, right?
My uncle said it don't matter where you go as long as you get that paper.
Man, fuck
exactly,
that.
Exactly, homie.
As long as you get that degree, it don't matter where it came from.
That's what people who don't go to Ivy League say.
That's true.
Exactly. Look, if they can retain and they got that crazy memory, go ahead, do that joint. But for me, you want to go to Ivy League? D's. Ivy League D's. I ain't going nowhere. I'm from the streets. I ain't going to waste my time. I'm going to take myself to community college.
So no Yale.
Well, first, you got to have a plan. That's first and foremost.
Yeah.
And you got to have some kind of ambition about yourself, some kind of worth about yourself, because your whole life ain't going to be Instagram, right? Your whole life is not going to be social media. Your whole life is not going to be the things that's important to you. Once you leave high school, trust me, 10 years after that, it's going to be so different, right? Mm-hmm. Maybe even 5 years after that. So make sure you keep that type of stuff in mind.
Yeah.
Right?
Nope. No.
Also, think about the majors that you're getting into. If you're going to do basket weaving, go to basket weaving, like a basket weaving trade, mm-hmm. right? Go to college that makes – college if it makes sense.
Yeah.
Don't go to college if it doesn't make sense.
Don't go to college for a coloring book.
Second thing, do something outside of college. You got enough time. Nobody's that busy.
Yeah.
We're really busy.
Make time.
Right?
Well, now we are.
Make the time.
Make time if you just going to class.
Look, you make the time for the cut. Yep. you can definitely make the time for the things that can make you money in the future, right?
So if you make it time to smash, you can make time to get some cash.
Exactly.
Exactly.
And with the
and with being so young,
you can make access and make mistakes and reach out to social media because it's what you do anyway. So you keep that hustle intact. Yeah. Another thing, meet a lot of people, talk to a lot of individuals. They can help you out. You need a team. We can't
LinkedIn.
Do nothing by ourselves.
Get that LinkedIn.
LinkedIn these nuts too. The thing is, like,
yeah, LinkedIn don't work with you.
Look, LinkedIn these nuts too. That's only if you're going to college. It doesn't matter if you're trying to build something. Look, understand what your worth is. If your worth requires
everything
LinkedIn,
these nuts,
everything's these nuts. If it doesn't make sense to me, look, check this out. LinkedIn these nuts. If you're not, you only need LinkedIn if you're trying to go to school and you're trying to be that guy. It's like, hey guys, how you doing? If you're not trying to be, hey guys, how you doing?
So
you're
wait,
trying to make
you straight
work.
Up. Represent regular
smuggling, you know, right? So
you talk about the dude who's gonna do just a little bit.
No, nah, a lot of it. But the thing is, he's doing a lot of it in a little bit of way. That's genius. That's genius, right? A genius will find some way to make something complicated easy. Life is complicated, so why won't you make it easy
for
yourself?
Are you talking about Eli Manning, his final exam, then he show up?
No, I'm talking about Eli, these nuts. The thing is, like, you gotta understand that. Well, you gotta know yourself. Eli knows it, so that's why he went to the league. But I can't throw that far. You know what I'm saying? I can't throw. I can run.
A lot of them do. You could go to the league.
I could definitely go to the league. But that's another story.
All
right. The thing is, I'm not built for that right now currently. Yeah. So what I understand, I got to use my brain power, my brain muscles. And when they be contracting,
that
they be
muscle,
telling me, my dude.
Muscle
his
that hustle.
Inner computer.
I'm from the streets. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to find something that makes sense. If I could do it all over again, maybe I would have got a trade.
Yeah.
Right? But what I did do, instead of, I don't do that, but what I do do, I don't go to the most expensive school because that means I'm going to set myself to go to the most expensive companies. If I'm going to an expensive school, I better bust my ass.
Yeah.
If not, I go to a smaller school so I can go with a smaller company and save money.
Yeah.
But it's all about making the numbers make sense. Mm-hmm. So keep that aware. And
if it don't make numbers, it don't make sense.
It don't make sense.
Oh, well, it don't make
bit.
Dollars,
so
it don't make sense.
A little bit.
Oh,
yeah, so if it don't make dollars, it don't make sense.
You don't make sense.
So with all this being said, in order to build wealth, you have to have one thing, man. That's ambition, right?
There you go.
And there's a cost to that ambition. And that's the thing that's holding us all back. So make sure you pay attention to these costs, right? Mm-hmm. There's something I got from InstaSnap. So
from the wisest man.
It doesn't matter.
Sources,
so,
my dude.
So the cost of ambition.
Gosh.
Yeah.
Late nights. Ooh.
Yeah.
Early mornings. Ooh. Lots of associates. Ooh. Very few friends. True. Right? You will be misunderstood. You will be single unless you're lucky enough to find somebody who understands your lifestyle. People will want you to do good, but never better than them. That's school, my dude. For that reason, you will do many things alone. So understand that. Make sure you're making the moves in order to achieve the things that you want to do.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Got
snap,
snapped to that.
Snap, snap.
I appreciate that.
Snappity,
appreciate
snap.
That. Man, there's money out here in these streets, my dude.
Snappity, snap.
There's money out here
we
in these
We can talk
streets.
About this shit all. This shit is so deep, we can talk about all day. All
right, man.
But so, let's... We gotta talk about some Atlanta shit.
Switch it up, man. Where we at?
So headlines, Sarah Jane.
So we gotta talk about. We have this one happened literally a mile from here, where there's a U-Haul. So there's.
Oh, it did happen a mile here, literally.
Literally a mile from here.
Okay, I'm in a very bad neighborhood, just for the listeners to know.
Bang bang.
Like this,
it's not that bad.
Used to be bad.
I guess motherfuckers are so the person ran a U-Haul into a Wendy's.
What type of neighborhoods you know that's good that do that type of stuff? It's a quick question. So they robbed a U-Haul.
Did they drive
the U-Haul well and crash it into a Wendy's? You know how close that U-Haul is to that
it's
Wendy's?
It's right across the street from the Wendy's too.
It is?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Literally.
It's like. Yeah,
so he must have been drunk.
It's like 200 feet.
What? Why did he crash into the Wendy's?
I don't know.
They said he couldn't drive it well.
It was an 18 wheeler.
Oh, they got the big one.
Yeah, they got the big dumb one.
He was whipping it.
For the big dumb
he
idiot.
He whipped that thing right across the street. Apparently, he didn't have his CDL. He wasn't focused for that.
It wasn't focused?
Wasn't sure why he thought he could drive a truck like it was a car. Don't know what he was thinking.
Don't they have like more gearboxes?
No. Might have been that.
Or they have like a lot
no,
of
No, we sticks. Drove. We drove. Remember when I moved?
But that's not the same.
That's not the same, my dude. That's diesel. This yeah. difference between diesel
they talking,
and regular.
We talking about an 18-wheeler.
A whole
It wasn't a U-Haul. It was an 18-wheeler.
Oh, for real?
I like that Wendy's, too.
You like
Let me pull it up for I y'all.
So wait. It was 18-wheeler?
Yes, Bruh. Sir. Jengar.
Did all 18 of those wheels go inside the...
That's just drove straight through it.
So wait, was Wendy's... So is that how the insurance works? Hey, Wendy's, so did 18 or 17 wheels go in?
Oh, you know what? It was a U-Haul truck.
Yeah.
I am about to say it.
It's a U-Haul
wheeler?
Truck slammed in front of Wendy's.
I never seen no U-Haul 18 wheels.
On Candler Road early Thursday
you
morning.
You rent those?
U-Haul 18
this
wheels.
This U-Haul was stolen from a nearby business.
It was stolen?
Yes. With the DeKalb County Police. That's what they said.
So they stole it.
It happened at 3 a.m. in the morning.
Oh, Jesus.
They left the club, bro.
They left the club?
And after the crash, the driver abandoned the vehicle and left the scene.
He bounced?
It appears it was poor driving skills that caused the driver to strike the business.
So did it catch him?
No.
No. Oh, shit.
Bro, you can't catch a free man. Hey, check it out. You can't catch
so the U-Haul bandit strikes again.
So talk about. This is not even a Friday.
He said, so watch me use.
So talk about. Wait a minute. This is why I want to talk about it. So if that's Thursday morning, then that means it's Wednesday. He was partying Wednesday night. So it went from Wednesday night into Thursday at 3 a.m.
You know the drill.
So how do you think he got to the U-Haul and said, hey, you know what would be a good idea?
Oh my
Let's
God.
Just, what made them? What if he was about to move?
What happened was he took that Uber. He was like, bro, I don't got enough money to take me all the way, man. Can you kind of spot me? Uber man was like, nah, I'm going to drop you off right here. He got out that car. He saw that U-Haul. He's like, man, I ain't walking for shit. Cause you drunk enough. Got in that U-Haul. He said, so why me? You? He jumped right into
So wait, did he hotwire it?
It doesn't say.
Don't nobody know how to hotwire. He Googled that thing. What he did was he Googled
how to steal U-Haul.
Did you say that the Wendy's was across the street?
Yeah.
It was literally. Stolen from a business called.
So it's literally. Not like literally.
It was stolen from a business called Maj. Maj. M-A-J.
I don't know.
It's only one U-Haul. It's the one that wrote.
I don't know. But that's where it was
stolen.
It's not
like literally across the street. But it's a liquor
like,
store there.
It's like 300 feet. It's
oh,
not, it's,
wait. Where the liquor store is?
Well, there's a liquor store right across from it.
Is it?
It's further up the street. Yeah.
Yeah, so they trying to drove off. But how do you... That's a whole lane you got to go.
Yeah.
He must have been, like, chilling.
It was 3 a.m. There was probably nobody on the road.
So he made a mean
Everybody
swerve.
Was on the road.
Oh,
you 3 a.m.?
They just
wait a minute. Wait a minute. You know what I just thought about? You know the precinct is right there. How did they catch him?
Come on. They don't care about these neighborhoods. They just live here. They don't patrol here.
The police precinct is Ferguson. Right there.
Oh, yeah, this Ferguson, is... Right. It's like when they park those police cars, but don't nobody be in it. Same thing.
They said the incident is under investigation.
That's what I'm
saying. Yeah, they gonna find that dude.
You ever seen a parked police car, but don't nobody in it? Same concept.
Or he be on his phone texting.
Exactly.
So by the time this shit happened, you miss...
Bruh, they send the real ones out to the mother areas. They ain't send the real ones out here. The real ones that's at that desk, they ain't doing nothing. They chilling.
The real ones are... Across the railroad tracks.
I'm trying to imagine this dude running to the store and get a spicy
hilarious.
Chicken sandwich and walk out.
Like, oh,
shoot.
He didn't order. You think he
if
grabbed?
If he would have used the grill, that would have been dope. That thing would be like, oh, boom, 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 boom. God damn. Shit, I'm hungry as a motherfucker. Get that thing up like, bro, man, off Martin. Come on there.
Anyway.
You know about the thing when the police come? So, just leave that thing with the chicken. With the chicken.
So, I'm trying to find out what this one is. October 22nd.
Uh-huh.
When was October 22nd?
Oh. That was earlier this week.
Oh, Gwinnett County, Metro Atlanta, Beaufort. 27-year-old woman.
Uh-oh.
Heather. I can't even say the last name.
Oh, she is.
Charged with reckless conduct. Of course, it's Walmart.
Walmart, bro. Walmart. We talked about that. Walmart.
So she got to the store about 5 a.m., but was found inside her car nearly 3 hours later as she arrived. Someone called 911.
Wait.
And she had slurred words and bloodshot eyes. And apparently, 1-year-old daughter looked like she's about to fall out the car.
Carmen. Oh, she had a 1-year-old daughter
in the not car cool, with her. And then the daughter grabbed the cigarettes until the police were able to. Oh,
too extreme for my blood. I can't talk about that.
Yeah, damn.
Wait, what?
Shit.
Her daughter was smoking.
In the car?
The mom was passed out at Walmart for some reason. See, this is kind of when people talk about, hey, we got to come to Atlanta, this type of motherfuckers that be out in, like, the metro areas, I don't think people understand.
That's why they got to listen to the number one podcast in Atlanta, just so they understand that you can't be making any mistakes out here.
Look, you can't, especially if you're a dude, if you're trying to smash these Atlanta chicks, make sure you understand. She might have a 1-year, she might be about passed out in a car, and her daughter got cigarettes.
So are you telling these said smashers to be courteous when they out here in these streets?
Yeah.
These savages out here, my dude.
I guess I'm just telling them to just be careful. You know what I'm saying? Just don't end up with the chick who's going to catch a case because her daughter got cigarettes. How your 1-year-old daughter got cigarettes?
She wasn't smoking.
That's dangerous.
She wasn't smoking.
I can't see this.
Yeah, that's true, too. That cigarette stuff is a little stretch.
You know,
because she ain't smoking it. She ain't like she ain't that thing just.
It doesn't matter.
So you think if
it doesn't matter.
So if the baby got access,
the baby smoking,
it don't matter.
Not smoking.
Nah, she got. If she know how to light that thing, she need to be in the circus.
No, no, y'all, what? If a child, what? How old is the child?
I have a hard time getting a lighter started.
Okay, so if a 1-year-old gets a hold of a cigarette, first of all, they're not gonna light it. They can easily chew it, and they can easily get sick off of the freaking tobacco that's in the cigarette. Are you kidding me?
First of all, I don't think they'll get sick.
If I ever find my child with a cigarette in his hand, I'm gonna flip out and kill whoever cigarette that is.
First of all, I don't think he'd be sick from a cigarette. I think he'd be chilling.
Yeah,
he's not gonna be chilling.
He'll be just.
It's a baby, fool.
He would have his arm up, leg crossed. Goo goo. You know what I'm saying? He would say, "What's up?" Go ahead, Bob.
Absolutely not. No.
So Barbados, you wanna? This is the last one we're gonna do, but we gotta talk about this one real fast.
Uh-oh.
This is called relationship problems.
Oh, we don't have those.
Okay, so. SWAT standoff in DeKalb ends without an arrest.
That's what's up.
Why are people not getting arrested in DeKalb? That's not good.
They don't give a shit.
They don't care. They just live here.
Yo.
That's
best, man. We got to start doing
First of all, they're just investigating. That's why there's no arrest.
Allegedly.
Allegedly, they're investigating.
Okay, so a SWAT standoff in DeKalb County ended without an arrest Friday night.
Okay.
Yo.
Channel 2. This guy reported that...
You said Channel Yule?
Channel 2's Gail Bach reported that a man was believed to be barricaded inside a home in the Circle Stone neighborhood.
Okay.
According to police, a 19-year-old woman was walking down the street around noon when she was approached by her 37-year-old ex-boyfriend.
Yeah.
Oh, that's how it goes.
That's our first mistake.
Matter of fact,
her own fault.
Were they at that podcast at one time?
Inside Joe.
You remember the last what's the name of the podcast? And that old dude with the baby.
Oh, that was
We gotta make sure she's still okay.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, somehow.
Police say the man was armed with a gun and the two got into a scuffle over her cell phone.
Over the cell phone.
The woman ran to a neighbor's house and they called police. Police say the man ran into another home and was barricaded inside.
So he immediately barricaded?
I guess.
Why?
He had to check them text. You know how hard it is to unlock somebody's code when you don't know the code?
Around 6:30 p.m., authorities determined the scene was clear and the man was not in the home. No arrests have been made.
Get the fuck. So, wait a minute.
So, he's still running around out here.
And she ain't snitched because you know he caught her. Oh, you going to call the police on me? That's what he did.
He texted.
He probably beat her.
Oh. Why you got to?
Why you do that?
Because he sounded like he would beat somebody.
The time of events, she was walking. Then he was like, hey, let me see your phone. She was like, nah. Then they got into a fight.
Let me see your phone?
So she ran into a house. Why was his first response to run into another house and barricade himself?
That's how he got away. That man's a genius. You got to take notes.
did he dig in the ground? Like, what did he do?
He barricaded. Doesn't mean he.
when they investigated the house, he wasn't there. The
so, bang, bang.
Let's not jump to conclusions.
What does barricade mean?
barricade mean you just dig under something, but not
no, it does not. I'm sorry.
I mean, okay, not barricade. Look, I'm intoxicated. It means you kind of like hide yourself, right? Oh, barricade.
That means you in, you reinforce so yourself within a structure, and you put reinforcements up.
So
nothing can get in.
Or out.
And you can't get out.
So, as I say, if I'm in a strip club and I barricaded some booty, that means I'm surrounded by strippers and you can't see me, right? So you basically hiding.
No. Never mind. Anyway, go ahead.
If I get into a fight, a relationship fight, I'm going to run to a house and barricade myself?
Absolutely.
that's the first step?
See, this is where you messed up. This is where you messed up. You got to understand, when they first met, he didn't ask her what her phone was like. He was like, hey, baby, like, I love you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm 40. And then she was like, whatever. You ain't nobody. She was texting, and you know old people don't like when young people texting. He was like, who you texting?
He controlling.
That's disrespectful.
So he controlling.
Yeah, cause he's like, why you texting somebody? I'm talking to you, right? So then he took the phone, ran, and he was trying to get that unlock code. So that's why he was barricaded. He trying to get that unlock code, right?
He took the phone and ran.
He took the phone and ran. He hit that lock code, and you know when you hit the code too much, it say like.
Oh,
like 3 minutes disabled for a couple minutes. So he was like, dang, he's sitting there trying to figure it out. He looking up on YouTube. That takes time. So you got to barricade yourself in order to figure it out. Right?
So you the police. He in the house. Blah, blah, blah. You go and search the house. Nobody there.
Well, first of all, those people who search the house, I don't think they searched the house. I think they walked in that thing, knocked. Is anybody there?
So you mean Channel 2 Lion?
Come on, bro.
It's the news, bro. Of course.
It's the news, my dude.
They ain't got no obligation to the truth.
Why would they lie for the police, local police?
Bro, they lying for a story. Because the real story was Buddy got missed a long time ago, so they had to edge it up. So then he jumped into another house. And then we looked in the other house. Then he jumped into another house.
So wait, you say a Welcome to the Wall podcast? Are we revealing how the news is lying?
Man, we dropping exclusives, man.
What?
We dropping exclusives, man. It's number one podcast, man.
So people need to listen to us to get the real truth. The real.
The real.
You saw the thing with Hillary Clinton, right?
What happened with Hillary Clinton?
Uh-oh. Oh, that's a whole nother can of worms.
The FBI. The
investigation?
They literally opened the can of worms back up on her email investigation.
Why?
Because Anthony Weiner had something on his phone.
Talking
something.
About the sex dude. I saw that.
Yeah. Ooh,
the buddy who was sexting.
Like, it didn't really have nothing to do with
he was like, I want to ski on you.
Some dick pics?
Yeah.
Man, what is it, a senator or governor?
No, congressman, senator, right? I thought, right?
Nah, he was. He still is?
No, was. Nah, was.
Nah, so
it says, whoa. So.
Bust him right out there.
Just a quick thought on that. So the Skim, which is a really good news app or news feed.
Do you endorse that app?
I mean,
it's pretty good. They're not paying me. I'm just saying. I'm just saying it's pretty good.
He says.
So basically, it says where are these email leaks coming from?
WikiLeaks, right?
So it says that it's unclear. It is WikiLeaks.
Y'all getting hacked in these.
But
I heard it's from a Russian government.
Where? Yeah. So it says that they're from the Russian government.
Exactly.
Wait, the government or the kids?
It's the kids or the government. We thought we was joking.
It's the kids.
I don't think y'all understand.
It says this comes after the Democratic Party was hacked earlier this year by groups thought to have ties to the Russian government.
Oh my God.
Team Clinton says Russia's doing this to give a leg up to the GOP.
They gotta be adults, my dude.
Donald Trump, who's given props to Russian President Putin in the past. Trump says not the case.
Play a 15-year-old in basketball right now. I'm gonna be dunking on you.
So it's a bunch of Russian kids that.
Kid.
You know what? I think it's Melania Trump's like family and their kids. They're probably hacking and like
you
doing it.
That's why we can't build a good internet security system because of all these conspiracies. Look, we got some 10-year-old kids jumping up on your stuff, and y'all can't believe that. Are you serious?
I mean, I believe it.
My
believe
little
anything.
Niece is probably like, what, 5, 6 years old? And she know the computer just as well as I do.
I saw a 3-year-old get on the phone, bro. He got to a point his mama didn't know how to get out of it. She was like, turn the phone all sideways. Like, what's that going to do?
Anytime you give him a phone, bro. Anytime you give him a phone, they assume it's touchscreen.
Mm-hmm.
Like, assumption. They in this thing, like, just moving stuff around.
Yeah.
Like,
a button.
What's going on?
Because they're smart. Button.
Because they're growing up with this stuff.
Every generation gets weaker but wiser.
All I'm saying, we get
weaker
hacked
but
out
wiser.
Streets,
that's
right?
What I'm saying. There's less than need to worry.